Here's one of my problems with Twitter. You fucking idiots keep begging celebrities to follow you. First of all, if you were all that, they would have heard about you from some other celebrity friend, and they'd be following you. So stop. Second, if you're just trying to get Snoop Dogg to follow you so he can hear how you can rap, stop. Because if you're really that good, someone will have told him about your rhymes or raps or whatever you want to call it from YouTube. Stop. It makes you look desperate, and it pisses me off. That's all. It's only 5:45. I guess it's time for the boy to get up. I just came back from visiting the ladies' room. So. Shit. See, this is why I don't like the goddamn microphone. Because when I put it on my shirt, it falls off. I blame it on the boy. Because I don't know what he does on this fucking computer desk. But when I come back, the cord is always really tight. Shit. Okay, I was gonna read you some of my tweets that I've been doing all night, because I've been up all night, because I fell asleep at noon, and I woke up at like 8 or something. Okay, so let me scroll down to earlier in the day. It takes a while, so just hold on. Hang in there with me. Because I know not all of you follow me on Twitter or follow my Facebook page. Whatever. Okay. I'm going to start from here. Yeah. After I started checking in with Get Glue. Okay. Hold up, hold up. Okay, but seriously, I am gonna say this because Get Glue, I think, retweets my posts there, and I was saying after I was watching last night, I had a pleasant nightmare, Suburgatory, that Shay Girl didn't think that smoking a fish for 4 months with its entrails, which means guts and all that shit, inside of it was wrong. I mean, how do you not know that when you kill something, you have to take out the innards because they start spoiling? And this is why girls need to know how to cook. Okay. My tweets. I replied to What the F Facts. It's Fanta, not Fanta, because I watched one of their videos, and their whores in the video were saying Fanta. I tweeted to Sam Jackson because he tweeted, "Dem birds, dem motherfucking birds, rise up." And I replied to him, "Why? Are you going senile, or did you just watch Hitchcock's The Birds?" I tweeted, when my son was younger, he you know, I'm pissing myself off today. I don't even know what I look like, because, okay, I don't feel like doing that, so fuck it. I don't even know where I was now. Okay. I tweeted, when my son was younger, he used to refer to the movie Hancock as foot penis, because he didn't like to cuss. Now, he doesn't like me to cuss. But that sucks for his fucking ass, because I don't care. Okay. And if you read my blog or watch my videos, you know that Paul Goody from Lolwork, or at SGNP, retweeted me and shit. Then I don't need to read that to you. I'm no longer following What the F Facts because it's the same damn facts I've seen over and over again. Kathy Griffin tweeted, yes, the bath mat matches the carpet, which matches the drapes. Because some dude said, just curious, are the hairs in your asshole also red? And I replied to Kathy Griffin, I love you, you crazy fucking dickhead. Then I replied to Whitney Cummings, it's funny to call other female comedians dickhead too, just like I called at Kathy Griffin one. LOL. Blah, 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 blah. So Snoop tweeted, time to roll an executive. And I said, if you really loved your fan, me, you'd stop by Chattown just to see me. I have MS and I'm in need of some medical marijuana, for real. And then, stupid girl, let me see what she said. Oh, she protected her account. Anyway, she had said, why does Snoop Dogg have so many followers and people like, I don't remember. I don't even remember now. Two guys like John Legend or some shit, they don't have as many followers. And I said, because he's an OG. Why is that even a question? And, yada, yada, yada. Scrolling. Sitting on my squeak. See, I'm pissing myself off because I can't speak. Sitting on my seat, scrolling my tweets. Ready to light this cigarette. I had to scroll down to make sure that I'm reading you the tweets that are actually funny that would make sense to you, because I don't want to retweet something that has been direct message to me, possibly, and out somebody. I tweeted, I just stopped tweeting back and forth with Paul or at SNGP. Clearly, I need a man who likes graphic novels, which are really comic books. Has wild hair, is learning written Mandarin Chinese. I could so do a guy like that, provided he likes fat black chicks with multiple sclerosis and is single with no VD or children or living parents or living with his parents and at least 35. Hook me up, Tweeps. Erky. Jenny Johnson tweeted, or at Jenny Johnson High HI5, tweeted, oh my god, there are people doing it on the internet. And I tweeted, no way. Does sarcasm read on tweets? And then I tweeted, are you ever shocked to see who people you think are cool are following somebody decidedly not cool? Because at Kevin Hart, for real, is following at Nick Cannon. Fuck my life. This is the one I had to apologize for which I had to apologize. At Jonzo76 replied to Eddie Izzard, oh my god, the sex change was, I said, oh my god, the sex change was 60 years ago. The individual didn't wait until age 60. Click the fucking links. And I apologized to him because, you know, I am on the rag. Oh yeah. By the way, I apologize for sounding mad at you, just dealing with PMS currently. And Robin Williams tweeted, you're single, ha 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 ha, ad nauseum. Me too. I thought that was funny. I tweeted, hashtag, who are you, when you get tweets and you don't know who the person is or why you're following him or her. And that was directed at Miss Penny Puppy. I don't know who the fuck she is. I don't know why I'm following her, because she's not funny. I don't get it. Damien Fahey, at Damien Fahey, tweeted, oh my god, here lies Brianna, RIP, with the emoticon colon, or is that a semicolon? I don't know. That thing with the two dots, and then the tear, and then the frowny face. Because those will be tombstones in 2060. I thought that was funny. I I tweeted, "Dear Lovebug 1136 at whatever dating site, I'm not paying just to know who you are. Better to just hit me up on Twitter. Because some dude, I assume it's a dude, might be a woman, I don't know. I'm not gay. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but seriously, I'm not gay. So I ain't gonna hook up with some chick. Okay?" I think the person replied on one of my YouTube video blogs, and whatever, the person sent me an e-card, which ended up in my spam folder. I'm pissing myself off, not being able to speak. It ended up in my spam folder because it's spam, and two, I was looking through my spam folder because I'm apparently already signed up to some other site, and I don't know what email address I used or whatever to get to that site. And so I clicked the link that said, "I forgot your password," and I haven't gotten the password, so it must be an old email address. Anyway, Ricky Gervais asks, "Will you be watching An Idiot Abroad 3 tonight, 9 p.m. Sky One HD. Tweet me your favorite things as they happen." And I replied, "No, but I'll be DVRing it, and my post will be retweeted from Get Glue." I tweeted, "Some bitch, that link was spam. Thanks, I need more of that shit in my life." I tweeted, "So, ILW, yeah, you have a purple dildo and you'd record it. You'd record it for me. Good to know." The dude replied back with, "What is ILW? That's in other words." I don't know all of the internet acronyms, but everybody doesn't know ILW? It's the same as LOL. Robin Williams, you should really be following him. I don't find him funny as a comedian because he's just too hyper, too caffeinated for me. I can't handle it. But his tweets are fine because I can read them in my own voice, so I'm not hearing his manic voice in my head. But he tweeted, "No, cough syrup, you're not grape flavored. Have you ever tasted a grape? You taste like death and the tears of small children, not grape." That's funny. "I've lost 46 pounds since March. Hello!" I tweeted that, but hello, for real. That's almost 50 pounds, you know what I'm saying? But I don't really know exactly how much I lost because, as I had told you before in my YouTube videos, that I had my son's steel-toe boots on when I stepped on the scale, so I don't really know how much I've lost. But just saying, 46 pounds instead of, you know, it might be 51. Hell, I don't know. But whatever. Continuing to read my funny tweets. By the way, fuck you at when you see it for not showing me the comments so I can finally see it and thinking I'm a 12-year-old, hashtag get your shit together. Because seriously, I was on that site trying to see it, and it said I had to connect with Facebook to prove that I was over 13. I was already connected with Facebook. That's how I got to that site and logged in with Facebook, so that I would not have to create another account that will spam my inbox. Anyway, here's another Twitter twit longer thing that I tweeted. "Dear Facebook and Twitter friends, I'm currently on the rag and I have multiple sclerosis pain. Do not read my shit until Monday to protect your own sensitive bitch-ass feelings. You have been warned, or just unfriend me now because I don't have the time or the inclination to deal with your bullshit." That's not bad, is it? I mean, I'm not that bad. Ricky Gervais tweeted, "Isn't Twitter the most fun ever?" And I replied, "No, sex is the most fun ever, followed by smoking marijuana. Short of that, yes it is." Eddie Izzard tweeted some... God damn it. Lord in heaven, please help me. Please help me to remember what I'm saying as I'm saying it. Okay. He tweeted, "Ugandan Kill the Gays Bill is still not gone. This time, as a Christmas gift for Uganda, please help stop it. Act now." And then he gave the link. Link. bit.ly/RNSOKX. That's if you're not going to look at my Twitter account. I think I replied to him, "I think I have signed it twice, because I think I have." Oh my God, Fax retweeted something, and I'm not even going to view the conversation. I said, "Cheeses and rice, not retweeted, because it's just too stupid. So sorry." And then I tweeted, "We need a short texting version for so apologetic, because I ain't sorry, but I don't want to type that much. Tweens, get on it. Hashtag I am lazy." Hashtag, "It may not be popular, but I always wear underpants ever since that one time at work." And if I haven't told you, and I'm pretty sure I have, once at work I was wearing a wraparound skirt, and I accidentally slammed it in the filing cabinet and started walking away. I wasn't wearing underwear. Luckily for me, I don't think anyone saw it, but seriously, back when I used to dress for work, which meant occasionally a skirt, I wore underwear after that incident. Okay. I tweeted, "Seriously, I got to go pee. Everyone stop tweeting for 7 minutes. Thanks." At one of my friends who lives in England, because she had tweeted, "Sirens went off. Have to leave the building." I replied to her, "Hurricane siren? What kind of siren? I want you to be safe. Ignore the siren." I ignore the siren because tornadoes only hit trailer parks. I tweeted, "Why do I only get my period in the middle of the night?" Which is true. Hashtag God hates women. I twit longered this. "I think I accidentally cut my inner labia when I was cutting my pubes with scissors in preparation for my fucking period because I couldn't find the 1/8 comb for my clippers. Hashtag I thought that area was supposed to heal faster. Every time I stand or sit, I get a sharp pain there. In my cooch. Hashtag God hates women. And hashtag fuck you, Eve, for eating the goddamn apple." Here's another twit longer tweet. "When you smell something disgusting and don't know from where it's originating, check the flap under your front butt. It's probably coming from there. Hashtag fat people problems." Because I is a fat people, and I swear to God. Normally I put baby powder under my front butt, but for whatever reason, when I last cleaned my front butt, I saw a little blood, so like I ripped myself there, you know, in the crease where the front butt flap meets my pudenda flap, or whatever you want to call it, I saw some blood, so I put Vaseline on there instead of baby powder. And I was lying in bed, and I'm like, what the fuck is that smell? And that Vaseline that I have is not regular baby powder scent. It's some kind of flowery scent. I accidentally bought it because it was the cheapest kind. And so I was like, what the fuck is that smell? And then I felt my front butt, and I was like, oh my God! You know, so I had to wash under my front butt and then go ahead and use baby powder. I ain't doing that Vaseline shit never no more. Never. Jesus Christ. Steve Harvey tweeted, "Change begins with yourself." I replied, "But I don't want to change." LOL, smiley face. Excuse me. Angelo Badalato, or at LOS underscore Angel, capital OSSS, tweeted a picture of the temperature wherever he lives. I'm assuming it's a he because it's Angelo and not Angela. And I said, I replied, I guess I should stop complaining about my 32 degree weather. Hashtag, it could be worse. I don't know whether to cry or laugh because I can't speak. Oh my god. But I wasn't going to retype all this shit. Unless one of my... Hey, that person who loves me, send me that thing, Get Dragon, because it's like $80. And I looked at, I looked at Amazon.com, and I can get an older version for like $25, but I can't get it this month. So until I can get Give Dragon and one of those headsets, I'm going to have to record my videos this way instead of blogging like I used to do. So that person, and I don't remember the name, and I'm not going to go back and scroll through all that shit to find the name, but if you go to my Amazon at ungavelyka1972 and look at my wish list, the public one, you should find Get Dragon, and you can send that to me. And that way, you don't know my address, but I'll still get the shit. And yes, I will to everybody in the world, on my blog and on my videos, that you sent that to me, and so they should thank you for that. And I know your address. You are not that far from me. So we could meet in a Walmart parking lot, and you can get me that Get Dragon. For real, you could do that. Because I'm not afraid to meet you in public. But I don't know shit about you, so I ain't meeting you in no hotel like I used to do when I was 20-something. Because I was unafraid back then, and my multiple sclerosis had not gotten so bad that just blowing on me could knock me over. So for real, yeah, buy that Get Dragon, and I'll meet you in a Walmart parking lot so I can see what you look like, and we'll know, both of us, well, I'll know if I'm going to do you or not. And let me know before you hand me that Get Dragon if you want me to be honest with you, like, no, it's never going to happen, or you want me to be nice, like, oh, thank you, but, you know, I'm really kind of in a relationship with somebody else right now. I'll be honest with you if you want me to. But as my mother always told me, don't ask the question if you don't want to hear the truth. If you don't want the real, honest answer. Okay? Okay. I think I'm done. Holy shit, that's a half an hour long. I hate it for you.